Here's that puppet I've been working on, you know? I've really been polishing this dude up, man. You know, very subtle. He's got like a little eye movement now. You know, his idle animation's really really cleaned up, like how it transitions in and out of things, you know? And his jump's really nice. That's just his idle jump. But when you're doing a running jump, obviously you wouldn't want it to be like this. You would want it to loosen up a little bit to show the momentum, but it has to loosen up in a very specific way, otherwise the arms get too crazy, you know? I got the wave on here still. Yade check. Watching Yade mess around with it, it was actually really, really insightful and helpful, you know? Because I saw her breaking it, just messing around with stuff, and going, oh, okay, I can fix that. Jump right out of it, stops waving, you know? Initiate wave again. Walk out of it, stops waving, you know? So, you still got the grab. I put a little sound effect and thing on it, you know? Now, the cool thing about this grab is, like, I'm facing this way. Boom, he rotates. Boom, he rotates. Boom, rotates, you know? Let go of it. Let go of it. If I'm waving, boom, off, you know? So there's so many state transition things going on, like, to do all this. Now he's got the idle, you know, the little bounce that I've got when he walks, you know, to make it look like he's hovering. That's in it, you know, incorporated in with the grab state too. And the idle bounce, which is a slight bit different because he kind of goes left and right as well, instead of just up and down. And then the arm does a different animation now for that as well. You see there's no hitches as it transitions, because the timelines are going up and going down at the same time and everything, you know, and then toggling on and off. Now, one cool thing he does, switches hands when you jump. I couldn't really explain this to Yade, because it was just like too much text, you know? But see how he switches hands when he jumps? And when he jumps forward, behind the back on some Harlem Globetrotter shit, you know, fucking NBA pro over here. Now, this is very tricky to pull off because you got to do it fast, but you can catch in there, boom, let go, and let go, catch again, boom. What the fuck else do I got going on here? I can't remember. There's this cool dance move. But I told you, man, like, I've been working on this shit like crazy. Now, some of these microchips are frozen. Because I would be like, okay, Daryl doesn't need to interact with these in any way whatsoever. But these control the arms. And then this, instead of, like, every time I wanted to keyframe something, I'd have to go in here and, like, open fucking every goddamn limb up. Instead, what I did was, nah, the mouse isn't public yet. I mean, D's mouse is public, but my remix of it's not public yet. Instead of, like, having to go in and, like, manually fucking tweak everything, open up everything every time, like, I went ahead and, like, put everything on keyframes so that I could animate it easily. Now, this does the posing. This does, like, springiness and tightness for all the joints and shit. And the reason I did it this way was because I tried paint with this, you know, convert to paint, you know, but it just would not act like an arm. It just would not act like an arm. And it looked like shit, you know, because of the complexity of the sculpture, having the little divots and grooves in it, you know, and then you'd have to make all the rest of it look like shit too, in order to match it. You know, you'd start dialing up looseness and everything. So I wanted it to be old school, physical connectors all the fucking way. So controlling all this shit and keeping the connectors from, like, spazzing out was so fucking tricky. So tricky, man. Because connectors are just, like, they don't want to act right, especially when you got a lot of them. Now, the problem with this, why I had to, like I was telling you, like, develop a new animation system. Let me unfreeze these arms real quick. Wait, I don't need to do any of that. I don't have them frozen. Wait, am I scoped in here? Now you start trying to move this, you know. Oop. It's not moving like normal shit, you know, like normal limbs do. Now everything's rigged up like limbs, but past a certain point, it's no longer actually puppet limbs. So they don't respond the way you want them to. So what I did to counteract that, to figure it out, was this. Now, hopefully I can... Okay, let me go in and close a chip. Turn this one off for a sec. Okay. Now, there's three sliders for each arm. One for the fingers, you know, to open and close them. One for up and down position on each arm, you know. And one for forward and backwards. See what I'm saying? Now, by combining these things, you can get different positions. You know, like, oh, behind the back. Oh, up a little bit. You know? And then keyframing that shit. Keyframing these sliders is how I... Let me rewind this a little bit. Get back to default state. Here's the waving animation. It's not really acting right. That's because I've got this thing here. This, like, custom controls the timelines. Like... to go to here and then loop backwards and forwards. Let me show that actually. Yeah, exactly, man. Yeah, exactly, Daryl. Nope. Let me open this. Okay. All right. Now you'll see what the timeline's doing with the wave. See, like, it eased into the wave while the other things are easing out. And then now it's only looping just that part of the timeline. And that's what that chip on the left is doing. So I've used a lot of those chips on different animation things to make things just ease in and out in just the fucking right way. You know, just the fucking right way. And each one's got a state that changes along with the animation. Changes the arm properties so that the springiness and the tightness and the radius and everything is all exactly the way it needs to be to control everything. I got this. This is the only other thing I got here. Making metal. It kind of looks cooler metal, but it also looks cool in the old way, you know. But it wasn't easy to rig up, man. Like, there's Yade's original one, and I really like Yade's. I wouldn't have done this if Yade hadn't made the puppet and was like, here, check this out, you know. But you can see some of the egginess to it and the closeness and everything. Like, you start trying to rotate this stuff, like, it starts, like, colliding into things, you know. Even if you cut it up, you know, I just had to really, like, restructure it and recreate it. And see if I can find some of the older versions where I started. This is all just from the last couple weeks, all these versions and shit. I'm telling you, because it's just where I do, like, major progress and then need to puppet rebuilt and rigged. Whatever. I don't know. There's the original. Whatever. You can see it there. I don't need to move it. But I'm telling you, man, like, it took a lot of re-sculpting work to, like, get everything connector-friendly and rotation-friendly and everything. And... you know, to be able to do, wait, this, you know. Wait. I don't know. Stop. There you go. Now you can see it a little better. To do all that kind of stuff off the center. The centerpiece is the actual waist, you know. And the reason I developed that animation system is so that you don't have to do all this shit with every single fucking limb by hand, you know. I don't know if there's a paint one somewhere. There might be. I think this one's paint. And see what I mean here, like, with the paint? Like, no matter how I got it, like, it was just too much looseness. Now, some puppets, like, work well with looseness. Some things work well with looseness. But this one, I was just like, this just makes the rest of it look too sharp. Too sharp, you know? So I had to go the old school way. I had to do it that way. Anyway, that's enough, man. I'm still working on that. There's still a lot of things I want to do with it. Yeah, right on, mofo. Glad you were enjoying that, you know? But, you know, these are all little bug fixes, little changes, everything, you know, like. But I'll have to delete a lot of these versions, otherwise I'm gonna run out of space with the new server limits and things. Working on this thing. No, because it's not. Here, I'll show you why. You know. Here you go. Come on, where are you? I mean, it will. It will, you know. Ah, fuck, come on, open it up. Here we go. Here you go. Now, see, here's the shoulder. Here's the forearm. Here's the hand. Shoulder, forearm, hand. Now, if you move this, you know, that'll move. But see how difficult it is to animate shit? Like, even if I put a keyframe down and I did this shit, you know. Oh, you know, and I was trying to think of you animating it. I'd be like, Daryl would just put down a keyframe and be like, what the fuck? Why won't it move? Now, after you unpause, the arm might start to adapt to this thing, but not properly without all the springiness and tightness adjustments and stuff that make it flow into the arm without all kinds of collision and bunching up and like jankiness and shit. But this would have been like impossible for you to fucking animate. You know what I mean? Because you would have been like, what the fuck? It's not moving. You know? What the fuck? You know, all that shit. So that's why I had to develop this system. Like, I literally developed an animation system specifically for it, you know, because that's the only thing that will give you these kind of movements that you want, man. Like, now see, the reason I had to explain it to you though was because I was like, I want you guys to understand why it's so complicated. A lot of people open up microchips and go like, this is over-engineered. It doesn't need to be like this, but it's all about the details, the details, the details, you know, the devil's in the details.